So now that I've been in Phuket, Thailand for a little bit of time, I thought it would be a good time to do a video on what my first impressions on arriving to this island have been. So I created a list and I want to go over with you now. Without further ado, here are the 9 things that I found most interesting to me and my first impressions of Phuket, Thailand. Oh my God, so it rains all the time in Thailand. Whew. I've been here for a month and it has rained almost every day but 2 since I've been here. Now the good thing is usually when the rains come, you know, it rains for 30 minutes to an hour and then it passes by. But some days like today, you get torrents. I came here in October, which is still in rainy season, and we're now in November, the middle of November. I've been here a month, and it continues to rain all the time here in Phuket, Thailand. So, bring an umbrella. The mosquitoes are absolutely horrendous here. I have gotten eaten up the entire time I've been. Now, I'm from the American South, so we got mosquitoes. Never really had that problem at home. Other people would get eat up, but for whatever reason, I didn't. And again, when I went to the Philippines and stayed a lot of time there, very rarely do I get attacked there. But here in Phuket, it has been non-stop munching on Dr. Lawai. Phuket has some of the greatest beaches in the world, and certainly some of the greatest beaches that I have ever seen. And just off of the coast of Phuket, about an hour away in a different province, is the Phi Phi Islands, which are the most amazing things I've ever seen in the ocean. The food in Phuket is just amazing. It's really tailored to where you can get just about anything you want to. There's lots of Western food here because it is a very touristy place. So things like McDonald's, Burger King, Swenson's, are available. Because Phuket gets tourists from all over the world, you have a ton of different varieties of food. You can have Korean barbecue, you can have Japanese, Italian, different Mediterranean foods, American fast food restaurants, if that suits your tastes. And of course, the wonderful Thai dishes. Now, some of the absolute best Thai food that you can have are these little roadside stands, these little restaurants right along the roadside that, you know, they just have 3 or 4 little open air tables and they're absolutely delicious. The drivers, oh my God, they are so crazy. Renting a car and driving it around has been a real challenge because a lot of times the people here drive down the wrong side of the road, especially when they're on motorbikes, because, you know, it's just quicker to get there. And you really have no way to anticipate what anybody's gonna do, because there is absolutely no logic to some of the driving. They also drive on the wrong side, or the wrong, it's their right side of the road, but to me it's the wrong side. So they drive on the left-hand side of the road, and the steering wheel is on the right-hand side of the car. So it's been an adjustment to get used to that. I had driven those before, back when I lived in the United Kingdom. So I had a little bit of experience in it, but I definitely would not suggest riding a motorbike for the very first time here in Phuket, Thailand. All the time wanting to say that, because they both have P's. Phuket has some of the most amazing shopping that I have seen. And on my journey this year, traveling the world, it is by far the greatest shopping that I have incurred. There is an amazing mall in old Phuket town called the Central Festival Mall, and it is on two sides of the roads. It has world-class shopping, and then just down the road from it, you have all sorts of markets. There's a night market just up the road, literally a 5-minute drive. And then there are also other places if you just need sort of like a Walmart or a grocery store, such as the Big C supermarket or the Lotus supermarket. The infrastructure here is absolutely amazing. The roads are just in really, really good condition, much better than where I come from in the United States. The internet is incredible. It is so fast. You could not find internet in the United States that I've ever seen that is reliable, as fast, and as inexpensive as it is here in Thailand. Also, the internet is so cheap. For mobile, I get unlimited data. The speed's about 10 megabytes a second, and I pay right at $10 a month for that, which includes my cell phone service. My final impression of Phuket, Thailand is that after everything that has happened in the world for this last almost 2-year period, it is finally coming back alive. The stores are reopening, the tourists are coming back slowly but surely, and that the beaches that were once empty when I first got here on this trip are already starting to show signs of life, with food vendors out and people actually bathing on the beach and not having it simply all to yourself. Overall, my first impressions of Phuket, Thailand have been wonderful, and I cannot wait to come back here again in the following year of 2022.